Talking about a very talked about topic recently, everybody wants to know whether the changing lifestyle has brought any increase in incidence of cancer. Well, whether the actual incidence of cancer has increased or not, we are really not sure, but cancer is brought more often to medical attention now. A patient who would die of unknown causes in the past would now be, because of recent new diagnostic modalities, would be diagnosed with cancer. But there has been change of lifestyle which has also increased the risk to a certain extent. There is urbanization and there is, yes, industrialization, which increases the exposure to certain chemicals, certain radiation toxins, such certain dyes or chemicals which increase the risk per se. But other than that, there are certain lifestyle changes like increased tobacco consumption, which could be not just smoked tobacco in the form of cigarette or bidi, but it could be smokeless tobacco in the form of increased gutkha consumption, which has increased the risk of head and neck cancer. Smoked tobacco would actually increase the risk of lung cancer, as we all know. And then increasing use of hookah in the young or the college goers today, which has again added to the risk. Besides that, our changing lifestyles in the form of sedentary activities, in which we are more oriented just in front of the desk, or would have a work profile which makes us have very less physical activity. This would ultimately lead to significantly reduction of physical activity and increased weight gain. This has known established risk factor for colon, breast, and sometimes prostate cancer. So, increasing physical activity right from very early childhood would actually contribute significantly to preventing cancer risk in future. Having a healthy weight right from early childhood again is a very important factor to prevent cancer. Now the next is increasing alcohol consumption, which is known to be an established factor for various type of cancers. And when we have a combination of alcohol and tobacco, then the risk actually multiplies, not just adds up, but multiplies, including risk of stomach cancer, head and neck cancer, and including bladder cancer, etc. Besides this, so late marriages, late childbearing, and very reduced breastfeeding has contributed significantly to breast cancer, which is the most common cancer in women currently across the globe. Cervix cancer is predominantly associated with poor personal hygiene, multiple sexual partners, and of course, risk of certain viruses like human papillomavirus. Prostate and colon cancer, as I said before, is very definitely related to high calorie intake. So a low calorie diet, which is rich in proteins and low in fat, is known to be protective for all these cancers.